Okay, now let's put this methodology to work. Specifically, we're going to look at how to synthesize a TCP/IP protocol stack using this methodology. Starting point, of course, is the I/O automata. We specify the protocol in all the detail that we want abstractly. That's the abstract specification of the protocol. And we can prove that this abstract specification meets the properties that we want in the protocol using the I/O automata framework. And from the abstract specification, through a whole bunch of refinements, we can get to the concrete specification. We saw that already. Those are the two steps that we already mentioned how we take in synthesizing complex software. But the next part, how do we synthesize the stack from the concrete spec? Or in other words, how do we generate this code, the OCaml code, that represents this abstract specification for the TCP/IP protocol stack? So we need to have a starting point for that. The starting point to get an unoptimized OCaml implementation starting from this concrete spec is to use this Ensemble suite of microprotocols that the authors of this Ensemble paper that I've assigned to you have synthesized at Cornell. Why use Ensemble? Well, remember, our goal is to mimic the methodology that is used in building VLSI, large-scale VLSI circuits. I mentioned at the outset that today, building a billion transistor CPU chip, the way it works is they use a component-based design, taking components of hardware structures that have already been implemented and assemble them together in order to realize this big mammoth chip. And we are trying to do the same thing for building complex software systems. So the starting point has got to be a set of components, and that's what Ensemble suite of microprotocols give you. Now, if you think about a protocol like TCP/IP, that protocol has a lot of features in it, and each of those features require non-trivial amount of code building. So for instance, TCP/IP has mechanisms for sliding window management, flow control, congestion control, scattering and gathering packets in order to assemble messages into units that can be delivered to the application. All of these things are features of the TCP/IP protocol, and the Ensemble suite of microprotocols has components for each of those functionalities that you might have in any complex transport protocol like TCP/IP. And if you recall the paper that we read earlier by Theckett and Levy about optimizing RPC in a local area network, we said that one size fits all is not a good way to think about designing complex software systems. Depending on what the environment is, we have to adapt what the layers of system software do. And therefore, even though the TCP/IP protocol is well laid out in terms of what the functional requirements are, whether we need all of the components in a particular implementation of TCP/IP or not is something that is up for the designer to decide. And having a suite of microprotocols gives you that freedom to mix and match the components that make sense in the specific environment for which you're building a protocol stack. And that's the reason for using the Ensemble suite of microprotocols. It has about 60 microprotocols that make up the whole Ensemble suite. The suite of microprotocols of Ensemble is written in OCaml and facilitates component-based design of a complex system such as TCP/IP protocol stack. And the microprotocols have well-defined interfaces that allows composition. Every microprotocol has an interface for the layers that sit on top of it, an interface for interacting with layers that sit below it, and this is exactly the kind of component that you want so that you can actually assemble these components layer by layer in order to get the functionality that you want for the original protocol stack that you intended to build. Just to reiterate what we said as the original goal, we want to mimic VLSI design in building a complex software system, and this well-defined interfaces of the Ensemble microprotocol suite facilitates component-based design.